Oh, crap. Jim fell off. Okay, that worked. The record is green, and now we hit the streams. Ready? Drum roll. And it went... It flashed red for a second, but it's staying green. It's not easy being green. Let's go out and check and see if I really pulled this off.
Hello, Mr. and Mrs. America, and all the ships at sea. Flash. Ham Radio now coming to you from the West Coast studio.
Oh, it is live. It worked.
I don't have a browser up. Okay, not have a browser up.
Easy being green. Let's go out and check and see.
Can you hear it?
If I really pulled this off.
Hello, Mr. and Mrs. America, and all the ships at sea. Flash.
Are you getting the audio back or no?
Coming to you from the West Coast studio.
Yes. Okay. Oh, you hear the audio. Live.
It worked. It worked. Woohoo! I did it. Okay. And Jeff's in the chat. Hey, Jeff. I'm not watching chat tonight if I'm doing this stuff.
I'll be able to watch chat. Pop out to chat.
Pop chat out to chat.
Popped out.
Pop out. And I'm not looking at Facebook anymore. In fact, I left one social media platform this week. I might leave another one. We'll see. So I guess we be streaming. So hi, everybody, which is Jeff.
Hey, y'all.
Jim's in the chat. We are streaming live. I can't tell how many people are streaming, too. But we're here and we're live and we're actually coming to you from the West Coast studio, from the garage.
I need more microphone in my face here.
From the garage underneath my parents' house from Mulholland Drive at the base of the Santa Monica Mountains. We're going to do this again in about 7 minutes.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, look, Jeff said hi to everybody but Gary. Are you guys not on speaking terms?
I don't know.
Doesn't say, where does it say how many people are watching?
Seven. No.
Jeff says eight.
Eight.
I don't see where it says it, though. Oh, yeah. Eight are watching. Nope. No one left. It's okay.
That might have been me.
Don't let the door hit your butt on the way out.
Y'all.
Oh, now we're down to six. Wait, we're doing this. We are doing this. Who thought I'd be able to do this tonight? Raise your hand. That's what I thought. Oh, did you think? I did. I wasn't sure.
Got to give you encouragement.
I wasn't sure. I have been playing around out here, and I did some recording stuff, and you cued me into the Windows updates like to turn you into a mono recording person, and I did notice that the other day, and that fixed it. It only took three reboots to do that, and then actually I fixed it, and then it rebooted because of Windows update, and it undid itself, and then it fixed it again. So thank you. I can't even thank Bill Gates anymore because he left the building. But otherwise, six minutes, Slim Shady. 6 minutes.
Six watching now.
Yep. Okay, cool. And we got Jeff in the chat and we got other
They
people.
Saw I was on and said, oh, I'm getting out of here.
They're leaving. All right. I am still shiny forehead. Hold on, I'm going to try to fix that.
Yeah, I spent about an hour screwing around with my lighting, and I think I have human lighting now.
You look good. Excellent. Real good picture.
Had to have a little color in here.
Yeah, rub it in, okay? How about that? Am I a little less? No, I'm still shiny.
You too can ask your kids to give you podcast lighting for Christmas.
No, there's just they unfortunately they took away all the hair. That's the problem. And still, hold on.
Powder.
I'm gonna try one more thing.
Get a wig. Oh. A rug. Okay.
I'm not getting a wig, and I'm not dyeing my hair. I'm not doing any of
that. Dye your scalp.
Yeah, you can do it without hair. Gary pulls it off.
Yes, I do. Me and my little avatar
Your avatar is a lot more pale than you are. I was going to say white, but, you know, that wouldn't be woke.
I proved that I'm white to the...
Did you hear the crash when I fell off the ladder?
South Carolina Police Department, when they gave me my warning ticket for not having a license plate light.
Just imagine how bad that could have gone.
I was driving while white. I made a good choice to what color to be on that. We have a new word. I'm going to try to
look at that.
Add to the vocabulary. David and I did a 3.5 hour promo earlier today. and
was it 3.5 hours?
It was over three.
Okay.
And so I forget who it was. It might have been Cornbread. He called it a promore.
Promore, yeah.
And I don't know if he intended to do that or not. He hasn't fessed up to it.
Cornbread is wicked with the puns and the whatever. So I bet it was him.
He might have meant it.
I bet he meant it. I bet he was in it to a minute. I don't know how I'm going to do the... I'm going to have to click over there and then click back over here. All right, the next thing I got to do is build some scenes for the Stream Deck. Coming soon to a show near you.
Okay, got test. Mm-hmm. First of all, testing bringing up the PC audio and not accidentally sending anything. Let's see how the music sounds to you.
Doesn't sound like anything.
Are you getting music?
Oh, there it goes.
Zoom making the music go away.
It's lame.
Did Zoom kill the music?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
Can you pop in the chat the link to the music on?
It's a long ways away for me.
Okay, no, don't worry about it. We can just do it. Dun 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 dun. You know, I could probably open another show and play the music from another show. Except they'll be talking over it, so it's not going to work good. Hey, Cornbread. Okay, tell us, Cornbread. Was a pro more? That was a plan. That was like, that wasn't your bad typing. That was the way you roll, right? You planned it that way.
If indeed it was him who said that.
Oh, I thought you said it was him.
I think it was.
Yeah.
But there were a couple other people there.
If it was, then I would think maybe my son. And
I'm frankly not all about giving credit.
Yeah, well, that's okay.
Nobody gives me credit for anything.
Okay, so I'm going to... I got to get ready to do the fly-in. And then we got the bug. I think we're good. I think I might be able to do this. And I got the... Oh, that's not a good shot.
Very dark.
Is it too dark? Oh, this one's dark.
This one's
dark. But you know what's not happening here? There's only a little bit of shine. I like the little bit of shine and not a lot of dark.
If you got all the lights turned off, there won't be any shine.
But if I turned all the lights off, you know who would be sitting in the dark? It would be this guy sitting in the dark.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. I have 45 seconds.
Need my show notes.
Wait, did you do notes?
I did.
All right. I'm not doing it. Did you get...
I'll guide us through the notes. There's nothing too serious about it.
And let's do brevity tonight.
Not our strong suit.
I know it's not. But I'm gonna help.
You have the button.
I'm gonna help move us along. I'm gonna be like, hey, open, go downstairs and look at your car, Gary. And then we'll come back up and we'll say bye.
No, I got all this cool extreme Elmer stuff.
Oh, that's next week's show. Because that doesn't go along with the show title of the new rig. Who dis? Oh wait, no.
Just in case you've never noticed, nothing does.
I know. New rig.
Who dis?
New.
Do you know where that comes from?
I looked it up on the internet, but in that it's new radio. I found that
rig and radio are the same thing.
Well, okay, I guess that's true.
Rig is just a hamism for radio.
So, ready for this?
fly that puppy.
Did it work?
People, it did. The people out there hear the whoosh. We don't.
I didn't even see it. I didn't see it fly.
Oh, it flew and it's sitting there like a bump on a log.
This is Ham Radio Now, episode number 451, New Rig, Who Dis? I am this guy, David Goldenberg, W0. Oh, wait, it's still going. Oh, no, that was on the other screen. I'm David Goldenberg, W0DHG, West Coast host, and we are live from here in the garage under my parents' house, along Mulholland Drive, at the base of the Santa Monica Mountains. And we've got Q-Mobile pilot. Go ahead, take it, Gary.
And from the studio in the bonus room above the garage on the north side of Fort Mill, South Carolina, in the shadow of Charlotte, in the foot of Mount Belzoni, I'm Gary Pierce, K4AAQ. I'm ARVN, apparently.
I don't know. That was what's and the Q-Mobile pilot.
Oh, I see it. It's covered up by my audio stuff here.
Oh, yeah.
Q-Mobile pilot.
And, yeah, we're going to give you a shot for that later. Can you actually take it out and drive around the block? No,
I'm not really dressed for it. I'm in my pajamas.
All right, I got it. And
I've been demoted.
Oh, you know, this
from
is
the base of from the base of Mount Eminem in the heart of Silicon Valley, Jim, NO1 PC.
Okay, you're really loud, but it's good.
Yeah, you're really the NorCal host, not the Bay Area correspondent. But
all right, well, I'm still
working on it.
Catching
he's working
up
on
to all
it.
This. Look at that. Oops, too many.
Hey, I got a mid-show promotion.
Got a promotion.
I'll expect to see that in my check on Friday.
Double your promotion.
I will double your pay. All right. So, new rig, who dis? What are we talking about? Somebody got a new rig?
First, I need to explain that this being episode 451, for the past 20, 30 episodes, we've been in the 440 band. Now we're at 451. We're out of band.
Out of band.
Until we get to episode 900 or 901 or wherever the ham band starts up there.
902.
Yeah, 902.
We got a ways to go.
Yeah. So we're out of band. And the SWR is just going to skyrocket. And my comment on that is that back in the 60s, I got a citation pink slip from the FCC for operating out of band on 20 meters. It says here, ask me about it, but you don't have the
hey Gary.
Ask about that.
Why were you out of band on the 20 meters?
And by the way, a pink slip was not pink. It was, I think, kind of grayish. And due to sloppy record keeping on my part, I don't still have it. I would love to be able to show it. My station when I was a general was a Heathkit DX100 transmitter and a Hammerland HQ110. Receiver, and I had a 40 meter dipole, and one day I decided to see if I could tune it up on 20 meters. I was a pretty much of an idiot, although as Jim mentioned it some time ago, if you have a tube transmitter, it's pretty much all band. You know, it doesn't matter what the impedance of your feed line is or your SWR is. You can get the tubes to send some RF down the line. So I was able to tune it up, and I thought I had copied some, maybe a Japanese station or something down on CW at the very low end of 20. And so I zero beated and I called him, or maybe I called CQ, or I think I was calling CQ. Anyway, whatever it was, it didn't work out. The only people that heard me was the FCC monitoring station, because I was a couple of kilohertz off the bottom of 20 meters. Those radios are not very well calibrated. And I guess I didn't, they have a crystal calibrator. You can find the band edge, but apparently I didn't do that. I thought, looking at the dial, I thought I was inside the band. But I was not. And what they wanted was, first of all, send in my logs, which I had, fortunately. And then write an essay about how this was not going to happen again.
Did you make any contacts when you were out of band?
No,
that was in the log. Okay,
nobody called me. I had nothing in the log. I did have the CQ in the log, you know, like at 14.0 011 or something like that, whatever I thought I was on.
So did they send you a penance that said you must write on the board 100 times, I will not go out of band?
Yeah.
I will not go out of band.
How many words did your apology letter have to be?
I don't think it's specified, but it's been a while. You still got the title up here.
Did they know that? All right, I'm working on it.
Make that go away.
Did they know that you were, how old were you?
60s. That would have been like 18, 17, 18, somewhere in there.
All 13. Right. I was thinking if you were like 12, it makes sense to read or write your sentences over and over again. I will not operate out of band. I will not operate out of band. We're going to make you do that. Say that 1,000 times. That'll be show 452.
We're not saying anything about the capabilities of this Anytone radio and the edges of the handband.
Yes.
We're not mentioning that.
Oh, that it'll transmit on FRS and GMRS and here and there and everywhere?
Will it do that?
Yes, it will. Yes, it. Well, it depends on where it came from, but the one I got that now was stolen out of my car would, if I had wanted to, which I wouldn't.
Yeah. For the folks that didn't stick with us for the 3-hour promo for the show, the promo, you might want to explain what happened. And I'll fire up my phone and get ready to go down and see the.
Whee!
Well, there's some stuff to show before I go down there.
Okay. Well,
fire up the radio.
Really quick, in 2 minutes or less. Went up north to the NorCal area. I didn't stop to see Jim because he was out of the direction of the path of travel. See my daughter in Davis. We went down to San Francisco because she wanted to go see some STEM stuff at the Exploratorium. We parked in the big lot across the street that is only coin operated or card activated. It's not monitored by an attendant. And after being gone for 4.5 hours, I returned to the car to find that the window's broken out, and they pulled the back seat out and got into the trunk and took my backpack with my laptop, my nice CF53 Toughbook, and my Anytone HT, and various and sundry other little junk. And the nice lady who took my police report from the 311 system there said, "Let me guess, you're driving a rental car with out-of-state license plates." How did you know? She's like, "Oh, we process dozens of those every day." Like,
and do nothing about them.
And they, they made a police report because I need a police report for Hertz and for my insurance company if I decide to tell my insurance company about it. I may just pay for the window because who knows.
So probably their rental company was not too surprised.
In fact, when I went to the counter, after I turned the rental car counter, he was real happy to hand me the clipboard. I filled out my report and he gave me a little slip saying, "Go in the counter and they'll give you a replacement car." The guy at the next window over, the agent there was like, "Would you like to get the insurance
car?"
Yeah. Would you?
You broke our car. We'll give you another one.
Yeah. Well, and she was telling the guy in the next window over, she's like,
"Just down the road.
You should get the insurance if you're going into San Francisco where you are, because they like to break windows on the rental cars." And he's like, "Oh, I don't know." And I was like, turned over. I'm like, "Dude, the reason I'm here, broke the window in the rental car." I was like, "Ask them for the car with the California plates." Maybe a little less likely. But anyhow, that was my 2 minutes. I'm sad. It sucks. And
so your list is growing. You lost your Anytone handy talkie.
Yep.
Toughbook.
Yep.
And now your
the
Jabra.
Backpack, my Jabra. Earbuds. My Jabra earbuds. There's a Leatherman in there. There's a flashlight and a Logitech computer mouse and a bunch of other little crap. So that's, it's what it is.
Yeah. Should run up to San Francisco and survey the pawn shops and see if you can buy your stuff back.
It did occur to me to drive around the neighborhood a little bit, but what was I going to do? So
shake your fist.
Yeah, I suppose. Or get in more trouble. So I heard somebody got a new radio.
I just forgot. I'm supposed to bring up a,
Somebody got a new radio. Wait, we're not talking about my new radio.
No, that's not your new radio, and I can't.
It is. This is my new radio. And I know these are like, not. What did Jim say? This is Unitanian, right? Can you see the?
Is that a Yaesu 8900?
It is. And look, it's on the screen. Can you? It still has.
You put a plastic thing.
No, it came with the plastic on it.
And you'd never taken it off?
No, it was an eBay purchase, and I just got it, and it came with the plastic on, and it looks like it was barely ever
plastic back on it,
barely ever used.
Yeah, I have three, and they're well used.
Yeah. No, and I have one in my truck, and I know what the handles look like when you use them, the knobs look like, and this one, the knobs look like these have not been handled a whole lot. So I'm excited. But we're not going to talk about my new radio. We're going to talk about this guy's new radio. Or are you going to talk about something else first?
No, yeah, we can talk about that. I got to show you some pictures here. Hopefully the
Wait.
Go in full screen. He's going to try to go full screen with me.
I'm going to try. Look, I did it. Woo!
Boom. Okay, so that is the Q-Mobile with the radio stack disconnected. I forgot to take a picture before I disconnected everything. The ball that you see there is kind of the core that holds things. There's a an arm, and it goes to the back of this long plate. There's a big plate back here. And what you see on it are all the control head brackets. Now, the 2820 just had magnets, and these two things are, they look like brass, but they're iron, and the controller just clipped magnetomically to, it's not a word, but to those brackets. And then this is the bracket for the 8900. This is a bracket for the 7000.
Did you have to have the iron for those brackets specially made, or did you just get steel ones from the hardware store?
I just got steel ones from the hardware store and didn't even think about what they were until I'd realized that the 2820 head
magnets,
magnet, and they just happened to be,
they lined up
far
right
enough apart that just lined up. So
is that whole thing, so what, is that RAM mount? Oh, sorry, Jim, go ahead.
You're asking the same question I was going to ask, is what is the mount?
Yeah, it's RAM. Yeah. Parts, RAM parts and pieces, put together all kinds of parts and pieces. Sitting down here waiting to get installed is the 5100 control head. Sitting on top, which I did not take off because it was too much of a pain, is the Anytone 578. And the one thing that did not have a removable control head, which is a problem for David right now because he would like to put that in a car, but no place to put the body. So that's why the angle brackets are on top here at the top of the stack of this plate. So I can put that, and then I Velcro strap a scanner up on top of that. So, there's the same thing with a picture that you can actually see.
I'm not gonna mention. Are you in the garage? Because it looks like you're doing this naked, Gary.
Well, I have shorts on.
You got the leg there and your arm.
A couple days ago, because
sorry, I had to go there.
Summer.
I was more worried about cable management, but because I saw the early Q-Mobile and pulling up all the floor cushions in the back, and I went, yeah, okay,
yeah,
yeah,
yes,
you'll get to pick on him shortly about that.
But when you sit from the driver's side, things look impressive. When you look at it from the passenger side or the other side, it's a multitude of sins that get covered up.
Will Cindy even ride over there?
She will, but reluctantly.
Yeah.
She's kind of afraid of that stack of radio slapping her in the face in a rollover accident.
Yeah.
Okay, so here we are up on the workbench. Yeah, here we are up on the workbench, and here's that plate. And because the control head for the 5100, which is up here, is so much bigger than the control head for the 2820, that's a 7000.
That's a 7000.
So much bigger. Yeah, so much bigger than the 2820. I had to rearrange everything. Uh-huh. I had to move the 7000 up to the top. I think the 8900 could stay where it was, and then the 5100 was going to go on the bottom. So
I'm loving that power drill. Was that your grandfather's?
I was thinking when we get to the holiday episode, somebody can, we can put a GoFundMe together to get Gary a drill that welcome to the 21st century.
That may be one of my oldest possessions, probably from the 60s. Is that not a fairly current advice?
I don't think you can buy an electric drill anymore.
Yeah, you can't. You can buy them. But I could go.
What do you buy? A gas powered drill?
Milwaukee rotary hammer.
They're all battery powered now. Not ones you can plug in the wall.
It's just not very powered. I got a Makita. Actually, I got the Makita I've got, I gave to Cindy for her birthday the first year we were married.
That's an antique, too.
Do the batteries still work on that thing?
I have replaced the battery.
Oh, okay.
Anyway, drilling was involved and things were are quite messy. You can see the angle brackets are off. And then ta-da, or voila.
Wow, look at that.
And it's back. So back up on top is the 578, then the 7000, the 8900, and the 5100. Now it's mounted on there, but there's still a lot left to do in terms of wiring and stuff done in the car.
Yeah.
But there's what it looks like finished in the car with everything turned on. I still have to route a few wires here and there.
So yeah,
and
why is there another control head on your thigh?
The Kenwood.
That's the Kenwood D710, and it's actually on a mount and I want to say snake. That's not what it is. It's a flexible
arm,
yeah, that goes down and mounts to a seat bolt.
Yeah,
and that's the only place I could find to put it. I had it on a few other spots. No place actually worked.
That's when you leave on 5.2 and squawk an APRS.
Yep. So it's sitting here 44.39.
Yeah, APRS
on APRS and 146.5.2.
140. Yep. Yep.
Yep. Just sits there monitoring all the time, never hearing anything, never, never ever.
Yep.
Is that it? Oh no, there's the 5100 in the back under the back seat, and this is showing the 32 gigabyte SanDisk, which is getting plugged into it for putting in the repeater database, because this radio's claim to fame is that it holds your repeater database in memory. Which is,
but it doesn't stick. It doesn't stick out that far. You just pulled it out just to show for show.
No, the SanDisk, yeah, the SanDisk will go all the way in mm-hmm. when it's plugged in and actually operating in the, in the radio.
Nice. How many hours of work was that?
All day.
But you're retired, so it was a good all day.
Yeah. So.
So you want to go mobile?
About that database.
Uh-huh. Oh, the database. Oh, yeah, we're going to show the data.
In theory, you can make that radio look for repeaters, FM and D-Star repeaters, wherever you are, based on the GPS. And but where does it get its information? Well, it gets it from here. This is a website called dstarinfo.com. Welcome to D-Star Info. And then down here, D-Star Info ID 3151 5100 quick start guide. Quick start anytime quick start guide. Here we go. Oh, no, it's going to open up a It's going to open up a PDF.
It's doing it.
And it's taking a long time to do it.
We almost did it.
Yeah.
Yeah, clicked away.
I got to dial that back up again. D-Star Info. Okay, I'm going to do this the easy way. I'm going to do it right from the Googles, where it's got the repeater list downloads, which is apparently I was unable to find a moment ago. So here's where you get that database for it. Download updates for your ICOM D-Star radios and the Kenwood mm-hmm. back when they had a D-Star radio. It's used by something called a near repeater function that is based on your GPS. And the U.S., Canada, and Mexico FM data comes from repeaterbook.com.
Compliments of repeaterbook.com.
Yep. Which means it's riddled with errors. But every...
it pays nothing for inaccurate data.
Every repeater database is riddled with errors, and then the D-Star information.
You get what you pay for there, right?
Yeah. So let's take a look at that download. So you got to tell it where you are. So I'm in 27513, which it looks up and finds that it's in
Funny, that's not what's typed in.
Fort Mill, 2729.
There were a bunch of options, but...
29. What is that?
Did I say 27513? Yeah, that's my zip code from back in Cary, North Carolina, which is in the shadow of Mount Belzoni.
Well, that's your zip code. Yes.
My current zip code is 29715.
Yeah, that website could be way clearer because I'd be like, enter location. I'm home. Oh, that's okay.
You could enter your latitude and longitude.
Office chair.
And this is now.
Yeah. Okay, select radio. I had to go figure out which version of the 5100 I have. Turns out I have version 1.21 or something like that. That's firmware updates. So we'll tell it that. And now, this is a little unclear. Empty repeater slots. All this stuff is going to be figured out. You can get 1,000 standard memories. Okay, I don't know what that means. The repeater list length is 1,500. I don't know what that means. Yep. Your call sign list length is 300. I don't know what that means. Your name display length is 16. I don't know what that means. What I do know is that you can't change any of that stuff. It's all fixed. What you can change is empty repeater slots. Why would I want any empty repeater slots? I don't know. Mm-hmm. And percent FM. Well, I like my FM to be 100%.
Well, but then you're not going to get any of the D-star.
Plus or minus 5 kilohertz.
But you won't get any D-star.
Not modulation.
Yeah.
It's not modulation. It's what percentage.
That one I understood.
Apparently, I'm going to download a list, and it's not... Apparently, it is not going to be every repeater known to man. It's going to be delimited somehow. So how much of that list do I want to be FM? And how much do I want to be D-star? Well, there's a whole lot more FM repeaters than there are D-star. So this is really D-star-centric thinking.
Just flip it the other way. Do the 80-20 rule.
Well, let's go with 90% FM. Because there's only a few D-star repeaters around here.
That you know about.
I know about all of them.
That repeater book knows about.
And I know more than
some of the ones that repeater book doesn't know about too. All right, drum roll.
So, gonna download this thing.
Free virus.
I'm downloading it to ham radio now. Copyright disputes.
Oh, don't put it there.
Yeah, don't put it there.
Put it on your desktop.
Yeah. Let's go back to this PC.
No, it won't let you. Oh, things are. That's all grayed out. It's like, nope, not doing that.
It'll get here sooner or later. It's thinking about it.
Wow.
Need a new PC again, Gary?
This is the PC that you got me, David.
Is it that slow? No. Something else is going. Oh, it's because you got 14 drives in it.
Yeah. Okay. I got a temp.
Index them all.
I think here we'll just stick it in the temp.
Oh, it's a CSV. So
I do want to take a look at it. Oh, I don't know if I've got...
just open it with Notepad.
I don't know if I've got a program that's capable of looking at it.
I guarantee you have a program capable of looking at a CSV file. It's called Notepad.
Well, yeah, that's true, but Notepad won't show you all the... it wants me to register Open Office. Oh,
yes, of course they do.
I have a better idea. I'm going to go over here to this computer. I'm at the other computer now. It sounds a little different. And right now it's looking at the RT systems, but how long is it going to take me to get where I want to go?
I don't know.
The D drive.
3 hours.
D drive, ham radio, equipment, a little more responsive on this. If you're hearing a little echo, it's because I can't turn the volume. My phone is listening to the Zoom.
Yeah, we hear a little bit of the echo.
I can't turn the volume all the way down. It's impossible to turn the volume all the way down. ICOM, 5100, repeater files for the SD card, and LibreOffice. There we go, LibreOffice. So let's see what it shows.
1,000,000,006. That's a big list.
Some repeaters in Virginia, some repeaters in Alabama, some repeaters in Georgia. These are all D-star repeaters. but it's kind of random. North Carolina.
Is there a location index in there? Oh yeah, the P and O and P are.
Yeah,
the key town. It's keying on southeast and some. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got.
Needs a resort.
Yeah, in town and in. Under name is the town, and under subname is the state.
Yeah, there's a latitude and longitude. You could use that; would be more useful.
Yeah, so I'm gonna sort.
You could actually Google map this, not on the show right now, but I could show you how to do that. Yeah, and you could actually take that spreadsheet and make a really cool Google map.
Okay, so now all the states are lined up together, and I'll zip on down to total. We see
a lot.
1,500 approximately, which is, I think, what it told me somewhere that mm-hmm. is what I could get. Obviously, way more than 1,500 repeaters around. So they just picked the states that surround the zip code that I gave them. And there's South Carolina.
A lot in South Carolina.
Yeah. There's a lot of repeaters everywhere.
A lot in North Carolina. There's only a couple in Ohio.
Yeah. I believe that it goes out to 100 miles.
Got it.
And then puts as many repeaters in as you told it to put
in. Yeah, maybe they ought to set a radius limitation on that because I can't imagine programming 1,500 channels in a radio, having the thing skip a couple of clicks, and you have to turn back 1,497 clicks to get your home repeater.
How useful would that not be?
That's not the way that it works. So now,
you got to put it in banks, back right? Here. Yep.
All right, it's time to go to the car.
Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby.
To the car.
All right.
So
you got to switch to the radio, and then I got to figure out how to switch to this phone. The phone on the other side. And meanwhile, Jim should talk, so he comes up on the screen. Except I may have pinned him. There he is. Nope, I'm removing the pin. Taking the pin out of the Gary Voodoo doll.
You were supposed to. Oh.
I was supposed to do something. You
were supposed to have said it.
I did.
So that.
I pinned it, but then I turned off the pin. No, it's set to you. It showed you and the cat. It showed you and the cat because you're a video participant. Even though you stopped your video, you're still a video participant. Oh, you're the one that took my Jabra earbuds, Gary Pierce.
How many earbuds do you want? I collect them.
Oh.
Kathy gave up on collecting them, the good ones, because the dog ate her last pair of iPods.
Yeah, you know, my wife got one from her company, had some company branded ones, and I looked at them and I thought, not gonna do it. It's like walking around with a couple of corporate earrings.
Oh, look, I'm the guy.
Yep. There's Jim. Hi, Jim. You cleaned up the shack?
I was just puttering around today because I was going through the stack of what needs to go to e-waste, all the dead iPods and iPads and you know.
Yeah.
You name it.
So I get it. Can you hear me now?
Yes, we can. Oh, wait, I got to go back to the screen. Yep. Okay. And you're still echoing a little bit. There's the green. Don't fall over the green screen. The
echoes should go away as I get away from speakers and stuff.
Did you warn Cindy you'd be
wall of ham radio equipment?
Did you warn Cindy you'd be videoing through the house?
I didn't.
No.
So this could be interesting, although I don't go by the shower area.
All right.
There's the stairs you can't see in the background because the green screen. Now here's.
Oh. Yay.
What the green screen looks like. See some of the studio lights. There's a big light in the background.
Not one, but two smoke detectors.
One of them is the Wi-Fi thing. Maybe it's a CO2.
Yeah, probably. No, it's probably, CO2, yeah.
So I'm isolated from the house by that door, which keeps the ham radio noise out from going downstairs, and it keeps the cats from coming upstairs
on
the carpet. And there is Cindy.
She's like, where?
Going, what the heck?
I saw that. She's like, what are you doing?
Why am I showing her?
She's like,
pajamas?
I got curlers in my hair and the face cream on. Don't put me on the show.
Yeah. Don't put me on TV. So here we are in the garage.
Oh, wait. What about that bumper there? If you pour boiling water and push out from underneath, you can pop that out. We popped it out on my son's car. He did the same thing.
Okay, I'll give that a try. So I got to put the antenna up and remember to put the antenna back down because it will not clear the garage door.
Well, it will clear the garage door, but it won't stay there probably.
Yep. Right, yeah. Okay.
All right, look at that. And then you got the Tar Heel.
Oh, I left a radio on. I probably have a dead battery.
Oh, no. This is going to be a really short demo.
Hasn't been on that long.
I solved that problem by having a contactor make sure that when the car is off, there's no juice to the radio box.
We should talk about that because I have a need for one of those.
And I'm not going to ask where he's getting his 12 volts from. It's going to be the wrong place.
It's my light bar.
From the battery.
Light bar.
From the battery.
Direct to the battery?
Oh.
What do you want him to do? Is pull it, tap it off of the cigarette lighter? The accessory.
No, we have to find the factory accessory point.
Yeah, is that enough to run all those radios?
This is a 2007 car. There's no such thing.
Okay.
You might be surprised.
All right, so let's see. Now I gotta pin the talking voice. Talk more, Gary.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is a test, but that's not how you pin it, but. If that's the way you want to do it.
Yeah, well, you're right. Good point. There you are. Look at that.
Okay.
How many memories are there? 830? No, B30. Oh, you have them in zones.
There's 1,000 I haven't. Yeah, and the radio does zones, and so I really like the idea of zones. It is a touch screen, so touch one side or touch the other to make it the main band. And then if you want to get to zones, there's a couple ways. There's this thing called Quick down here, which I think.
Jim, you got a DMR radio or a D-Star radio there?
Nope.
Oh, yeah, they don't.
Probably will never own one.
Me too.
They don't call them zones. They call them banks.
Banks.
And so I got the Fort Mill Bank. That's my local bank.
Oh, and you got 1-4. Okay, well, why did you put 14652 there? Because you got it on the other radio all the time. And it's the first thing it pulls up. I'm sorry, I'll be quiet now.
I just have it there. Okay. Because I need to use it.
Default, A00. Yeah. Oh.
Oh, there's the cars.
Yep, local repeaters. Got a couple of repeaters in Fort Mill. Nobody's ever on them. The DX group has a repeater. Also, nobody's ever on it.
Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. There's a networked system called Fleet Talk,
mm-hmm.
and their call is W4FTK, and they got repeaters up and down South Carolina and into North Carolina a little bit. They got a VHF here in Fort Mill and or Rock Hill, and a UHF, mm-hmm. and then one up in Charlotte, but evidently I don't have it programmed that way here. Oh yeah, I know why. There's another way to get to the banks. There's a button called bank. So if I look at Charlotte Metro, this is all the repeaters in the area, or at least 100 of them. There's more than 100, so I'd squeeze 100 in as best I can.
So can you pull back and fire up all the radios at the same time, or it's going to kill your battery?
I can.
You got to start the car first.
No, it won't.
We're talking a half an amp per radio.
All right.
Yeah. Yeah. People say, how can you run all those radios? What is powering them?
Oh, Christmas tree. Oh, Christmas tree.
If they all transmit it at once.
And then you drain it. Then you could watch
you'd melt all the power poles if you transmitted it once.
Right.
And the 12 gauge wire to the battery.
Right. And you can see the alternator, Volt goes.
Yep. Okay, so
nice.
Let me show you how that repeater list that we put in is actually used.
Is that got a different color background you could do on that screen?
No.
Purple.
Oh, that's too bad.
Purple.
That would be so painful driving at night.
It can be dimmed, and in fact, it's got an automatic dimmer. You can have it so that it dims, and then when you touch it, it lights back up. Or you can set it so that you have to tell it what time. So when does it switch over? You have to change the time. But like right now, I have it set for 5 p.m. It'll go to dim, and 6 a.m. it'll go back to bright. I'll never see it go to bright because I'll never be up at 6 a.m.
Never be up at 6 a.m. Only if this ham tries to get you out of bed for an early show.
Yeah, well, you did, but for you it was 6 a.m. or 5:30 a.m. For me it was 9.
No, I didn't even actually try to text you until it was like 7:30 my No, it was 6:30 where I was. Yeah.
Okay, so here's the thing. This is the DR mode. I've got an ICOM 880 D-Star radio, and it had DR mode in it, but that DR mode did something totally different. So I was not expecting this.
What's DR mode?
Digital repeater. So I punch up DR mode and these two windows come up here. And they won't mean much to anybody who's outside of D-Star. But it's also going to work for analog repeaters, and I'm going to show them in a second. I'm not sure why it's showing something from Washington. It doesn't make a lot of sense. So now we've got, I can look at the list of repeaters, which is what I downloaded. I can look at near repeaters, mm-hmm. which is what it's going to pick from that list based on GPS. Or I can look at TX history. I've never actually looked at TX history.
No, it shows you when you use the radio.
Yeah, repeaters. And it's remembering it from times not too distant.
You haven't used the radio a whole lot. It's still new.
Yeah. So now I would like to step back. Okay, there's a step back button.
Jim wants you to step back and show underneath the seat.
I don't want to see underneath the seat.
I'll show you all the wires. In
the I saw the box you have your HT and your APRS, Jim, and I know nobody else saw that.
So this is the useful button. This is the near repeater. As you drive around, that's going to change based on what you're near, and that's what you want to know about. So you got your choice, only digital voice or D-Star, only FM. So we'll check them all.
The GPS is an invalid.
Yeah, I can't see GPS, but the last time it saw GPS, it sorted the list this way. So the Indian land repeater is the closest to me, and the Fort Mill is, well, it's interesting. Am I at the top of the list? I guess I am. It's showing the Indian land, which is 3.8 miles away. Oh, and then the Fort Mill is 6 miles away. It doesn't really know where those repeaters are exactly. And I can dial through this list and see if I can find something that I want to operate. And we can see the list is getting progressively farther and farther away. So it's sorted by distance, which is pretty useful. And if I go all the way to the bottom, it peaks out at about 91 miles. And I've seen it go as high as 99 miles, and I haven't seen it go any higher. So go back to the ones that are close. And I think I told it to do a mix. So we're seeing mostly FM here. Mm-hmm. At some point we should see, there comes in a D-Star repeater. So that is an interesting and potentially useful thing. If I want to use one of those repeaters, let's say I want to use this Fort Mill repeater, then I got to touch that line. And it's now set up and ready to use. And if I give it a quick kerchunk.
Put your call sign out, Gary.
I don't want them to know it's me. This WA0DHF.
Yeah, there you go. You put my call sign out. There you go.
Um, Okay, so we can operate that repeater. It works. I was told the other day by someone who has one of these radios that if the repeater happens to use digital tone, that this list doesn't catch that field and won't plug in the digital tone. But in theory, that's going to get fixed with a firmware update, which is interesting because this radio first came out in 2015, so it's been on the market for 8 years, and they're just catching that now. But okay, whatever. Now, here is a complaint. Not that I ever complain about anything.
What? Wait a minute.
Now I want to go back to my list. I would like to just step back to my list and step on down. If I turn the knob, do I see the rest of the things in my list? I do not. I go through what is alphabetical in that list of all the repeaters, and that means that I could quickly go to something that's 100 miles away and useless just because it happens to be the next thing in the alphabet. So
you could spend a couple hours resorting that list to make sense.
I would have to change the names to, well, if the goal is to keep looking at repeaters that are near me and to go up and down the list of repeaters that are nearby. So, you know,
I see. Yeah.
Yeah. So once again, near repeater, all GPS is an invalid. So this is the one that I was at. Let's suppose I went down the list a little bit and went to a Charlotte repeater. Here's another complaint. I know it's in Charlotte, but I got a lot of repeaters in Charlotte. I got the call sign. I don't know what frequency that is. I don't know if it's 2 meters. I don't know if it's 440. I do know it's FM, and I can see that it is 12 miles away.
Oh, so you can't zoom in on that and get more information, huh?
I do. Once I tap on it.
Ah, okay.
Then I get the frequency and still keep the call sign. And let's see if that the key's up. No, it's either not on the air or too far away. 12 miles doesn't look to be too far, but I'm in the garage.
But you're in the garage, yeah.
Yeah. Now what I would like to do is go back to that list and show this repeater in that list and then dial up and down from there. If that's possible, I haven't figured out how. I do have some options for things. There's these menus on the bottom. But nothing will take me back to that list. If I tap on it again, I would expect if I tap on it again, it's going to take me back to that list. But it doesn't. It takes me back to the option to select the near repeater list. And so I got to hit that and then hit that. And then it's going to be back at the top of the list. It's not going to show me where I was. So that's a minor complaint, medium complaint in terms of usability. Could be a little bit better. But the idea of being able to find the repeaters where you are and not have to program in dozens of repeaters before you get on the road, that's pretty attractive.
We're losing a little bit of Gary's audio here.
Yeah, you're a little bit in and out, but that's cool. You know, it seems like it's like
talking as loud as I can.
It's fine. No, it's yeah. You know, it's like the Swiss Army knife of radios. And you know what they say? The Swiss Army knife is the master of doing everything mediocre because it does so many things.
Does everything equally poorly?
Equally poorly. Yeah, exactly.
Yep. One thing you can do from this list, say select that repeater. One thing you can do is put it into a memory. So you can write it to a new channel, and you can write it right over a selected channel. You can copy it to the VFO if you just want to hang on to it temporarily. So if I tell it to write to a new channel,
I can select the bank. I can select what channel to put it in.
That's handy.
Yeah. So that is a good feature. I wonder. Just for fun.
Is there
pushed all the buttons possible here?
Is there there's obviously a volume knob. Is there a squelch knob or is it all menu driven?
It is a squelch knob.
Okay.
So it's old school.
Yeah. I think that's better because it's accessible when you need it quickly.
Yeah. So this repeater is a tone squelch. So here we go. There's one that's just tone. So
yeah. There you go.
So we can give you a light. Maybe enough light.
Yeah, you can kind of see it.
Volume knob and a ring behind it. It's the squelch knob.
Cool.
So that is not every possible thing in the radio, but it is some of the interesting things. And I'm liking it so far. The display, although it's huge, and if you set it up to just look at frequencies, that would be huge. Let's
see. Well, I like that the touchscreen is functional because it solves some of the distracted driving issue. I mean, I kind of like that UI aspect. But
yeah.
So am I going to pay $600 for a new radio for it? Nah.
It's only $450.
I'm not making that much off YouTube, so yeah.
next month after Christmas.
I've got enough radios.
So what's the power buttons below that? That's you got a control thing for. Oh, that's the tuner for the Tar Heel.
Yeah, that's the Tar Heel motor presets.
Yeah, that's the don't drift too far off wherever you preset your Tar Heel box.
Yep. So. I guess I would always want it to show both the frequency. If I'm showing the name, I still want to see the frequency, but things get real small.
Yeah.
If I do that, I can also set it to be one display, you know, mono display, one side or the other. Both sides are still working, just only one side is going to show. And there's tons of menus and different ways of getting into the menus. There's four layers of menus behind this F key. F1, F2, F3, F4. No, well, there's three. And then there's a menu button that takes you to more menus.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
There's a home button that will get you quickly to
get you
whatever
back,
you tell it to
back go to. Back to wherever home is.
Yeah. And then there's a quick button, which has more menus that I don't think you can tell it what to put in this quick menu. I've got to go find out. I can put in more useful things than what's there now. And if you're talking to somebody with a D-Star radio, you can see where they are and how far away they are. It happens whenever they transmit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the Fusion does that. Fusion does that as well.
Yeah. And that's
pretty much it.
Pretty much it.
All right.
And now I will show you the. I think I got to get more light. Well, you can sort of see the
cable management or lack thereof. Wires.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But now I will turn the camera around and. Go behind.
Oh my God. Yeah. Oh my God.
Or we'll send you some wire loom.
Yeah, I've got some cable
stuff.
Round things that hold the cable cable trenches.
The Velcro or the trenches, yeah.
Yeah, but I haven't
gotten that far.
I haven't cleaned all that up. I it has been all cleaned up. It's been a lot neater than what you see here. But
it's okay.
In order to change radios, things have gotten messy.
It got pulled apart, and the back seat's all, is it all radios all the time?
I'll turn the camera around again here. Unlock the back door. I'm going to turn off these lights. So,
that's not so bad.
There's nothing sitting on the seats. I just, you know, got some jackets and actually towels left over from.
You obviously don't travel with a puppy.
Right.
No.
No, they're all cats all the time there.
Or a cat. Will there be enough light to see anything? Oh, yeah, I can turn on.
Apparently not.
Phone light. I think I can turn on the phone.
Not with the camera on. Can you do it with the camera on?
I can try. Flashlight.
Hey, Siri. No,
not going to turn on the flashlight.
Oh, never mind, Siri. I was talking to Gary's camera.
But I happen to have a light here. I just have to plug it in. A shop type light.
Oh, yeah.
So there's the radio sitting under the seat.
Yeah.
More radios sitting under.
Over there. Yep.
Yeah. So there's three radios under the seats here.
Wait. Go back to that. There's a power pole into a T connector, or that's just a red T connector. Oh, it's just a red T connector. Sorry. Okay. That's all good. You didn't have to show me that. It looked like you jammed the power pole into that one T connector.
Yeah, that wouldn't work.
That made me really uncomfortable.
Well, I love the tie. Wait. Go back to the back of the console. What's that big tie wrap? Up. Oh, that's okay. Superb.
that's holding the temporary installation that's only been there for about 4 years of the.
That's the light bar on the top.
Thing. Light bar on the top to one of my speakers.
And the speakers, yeah. Wee, and that's got a zip tie on it too at the top, right?
Yes.
Yep.
It's designed to be mounted with magnets to the roof.
Yep.
But if I set it with magnets to the roof, you could these rails block the
roof racks in the way.
Yeah. From behind. So.
Yep.
That's why it sits the way it does. I never made any representations that I am a good engineer, installer, designer of any kind. I am a hack.
Yep.
Okay. I gotta go back to my very first, very tentative radio install when I was 16 or 17, and I had to tear into the dash and console of a Datamaso Pentara to install a mobile phone. And I can just imagine what the guy would have done had I wired it,
saw the job that you did. Oh, right. Well, you know, to each his own.
Back in 2007, when the car was new, the installation was pretty clean.
Yeah.
But it's been that way for 15 years. And
how we accumulate lint in tie wraps.
Right, exactly. Yeah.
At some point in time, you got to go through the whole install with the dikes and get rid of all the tie wraps and start over.
Yeah.
It's just one of those Saturday afternoon things when football's not going so well.
Yeah. We all converted from I don't do the zip ties anymore. It's all Velcro all the time. Oh, look at the nice shelf of stuff. Dun dun dun. Kersky in.
This is like the first year that Cindy and I were dating. Look, I had hair,
mm-hmm.
and I looked thin and like really young. There's Arvin, the gnome, never-ending press conference.
Now, I love that microphone. I love that chrome mic. You gotta start using that in the studio, man. That's classic. That's a classic EV.
Sure 664, that's a Sure.
No, it's an EV.
Oh, it is an EV, yeah. Yeah, I have hooked it up. It had a bad hum, so I've disconnected the cable just to make it sit here easily. And you know how it was humming?
Doesn't hum anymore.
No, do you know why it was humming?
Why was it humming?
Because it didn't know the words.
Because it couldn't, yeah, because it couldn't keep a tune. Yeah.
Misconnected one, two, and three.
Because it, yeah, couldn't.
My order of the battered boot from the March of Dimes in 1979.
First so where's it? Did we miss the D-104 collection?
That's on the other shelf.
I have owned several D-104s in my life, and they are sadly no longer with me. I don't know where they went.
No, that's too bad. I just look back. I have five of them, and one of them is a Gold Eagle. Like that was a steal.
Okay, here's the view of the studio from behind the monitors and stuff.
To where the sausage is made.
Yeah. Yep. The green screen. The green shirt on the back of the.
Yep.
Okay, so I'll now terminate.
So I don't feel so bad about my shack wire management because of yours.
I'm a hack.
Just been here 20 years. I got Ethernet and phone cables behind the bench. I don't even know where they go anymore.
It looks good from the
camera. From the camera, that's exactly what it's supposed to look like. If you could see what I had going on here, it's the same thing. The same thing. Well, that was fun. And actually, this was just what the doctor ordered because my wife just texted me that she had to get back in bed because of the COVID. I probably need to go make her some soup or something. I don't know. Are you coming back on the other camera, Gary? Da, 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 da. There he is. There they are. Here I am. Nope, that didn't work. That's the one. Hi, guys. I think this was a quality show.
And the phone.
Oh, now you got...
has left the meeting.
You got the dulcet tones of Gary back.
But I can't hear anything because I still got the earbuds in and they're not connected to anything anymore.
Hi, Gary. You missed my monologue. But it's all good.
What did you say?
I was talking about what a quality episode I thought this was. And that...
Is it over?
Well, I've been beckoned into the COVID rebound house to go... take care of my YL.
So we get to retitle this as the ICOM review.
Yeah.
I was going to say Jim and I can stick around and talk about Elmering, but you're in control.
You could. I can come back and shut the stream down later, but we'll go all night.
I can't do the switching.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it won't work that way.
Oh, sorry, guys.
We've been on for an hour.
I know. Well, I already did 3 hours before.
Okay, so your wife has the COVID's pretty bad.
She had it and then took the Paxlovid, and then at day five she was feeling chipper, except for the taste in her mouth, and
to get the Paxlovid rebound
and no testing or whatever positive. It was all negative and everything was good, and 3 days later she's back to feeling blah.
Oh, good catch, Jerry.
So
on the chat, I hope Gary remembered to put the antenna back down.
Oh yeah, I don't think you did.
I will try.
You need to have a sticker on your garage door that says "Check antennas before exiting."
No, what you need to do is get a. You need to get a mirror up there.
Move before flight.
Yeah, one of those round.
I almost never put them up. Well, in the garage, which is actually more of a problem because then it's easier to forget.
Go do it now, Gary, while you're thinking about it.
Well, I have to fire up the phone again. And
No, you can do it.
We didn't need the antenna up to look at the display.
You could run down there and do it.
Or did we?
But don't run on the stairs.
Remember the repeaters I kerchunked?
Yeah, he did kerchunk the repeater. You know what? It would have kerchunked with the radio down.
WA0DHG.
Yeah.
Kerchunk. It would have, but I would have fried the transmitters because of the high SWR.
Maybe. I don't know. Kerchunking it would have done that. So
I short Kerchunk might not have.
All right, so let's carry Extreme Elmering over till next week.
Okay.
And we'll figure out something else to fit in the topic. I know you want to stay up all night, but you'll figure out something else to do with it. What else? Anything else to sign off? Any last words or thoughts?
I'm looking over the notes. Last things that people said in chat. But
yeah, mostly they said, go put your antenna down, Gary.
Jerry said that. Thank you, Jerry. What's Jeff telling you he's practically a vegetarian about?
I think they were talking about eating.
We're talking about chili.
Eating Arvin. Oh, Java chili. Oh, yeah.
Oh, guess I must have missed that.
So,
okay, if there's more than 4 seconds of silence, the show must be over.
I think we need to do this. Let's see. What do I do when I close the show? I go back to... This was Ham Radio Now, episode number 451. New rig, who dis? You want to explain this real quick, Gary?
Yeah, actually, with D-Star, it does not mean very much. It could mean something in DMR. I mean, this comes from new phone, who dis?
You
got a new phone and it doesn't have your contact list in it.
Ah.
So when the phone rings, it doesn't show you who you're talking to, even though it's somebody that you know. But for the most part, it is effective when someone calls you that you don't really want to talk to.
Got it.
So, new phone, who dis? And then you hang up or whatever. But on DMR, if you get a new DMR radio and you haven't plugged in the contact list, because you have to put that into your radio individually, then somebody could call you and all you get is their number, mm-hmm. and you can't tell who they are. And you could say, new radio, who dis?
I got it.
New rig. Sorry, new rig. I beat you into making a rig, and now I'm saying new radio.
You asked me to change it. I changed it. Yeah.
You did. You follow instructions.
I am trying really hard.
Yeah.
Really hard. All right.
Okay, so more Extreme Elmering coming up in a future episode.
Absolutely. We're going to work on that. David Goldenberg, W0DHG. And there's...
Gary Pierce, K4AAQ.
And Jim Aspinall, NO1PC.
Over.
And
out of here. That didn't work quite right, but it was close.
What didn't work right?
It got to black first instead of just fading in over us.
So is that something wrong with the shot?
However you switch it.
Uh-huh.
It should be on a layer above the other shots.
Oh.
And so it should just fade in over whatever the previous shot was.
All right, well, I'll work on that.
But you have to layer it properly on Wirecast.